In this figure, we're going to look at how skeletal muscle is stimulated to contract to differing degrees. And so this is somatic motor control, right? Controlling the skeletal muscles. And it's going to follow what's called a mechanism called motor unit recruitment. So first of all, let's look at our whole muscle down here at the bottom. Very simplified version, but we've got it transected here, cut. We can see we've got our alpha motor neurons coming in here, right? Our axons coming in from the spinal cord and innervating groups of muscle fibers, right? So in cross-section, these circles are representing those cut muscle fibers. And the muscle fibers actually fall into multiple groups. We'll learn more about that later in chapter 7. But those groups are characterized based upon their functional abilities. In other words, large muscle fibers tend to produce more tension, they're stronger, but they also tend to be more powerful in that they can contract more quickly. Smaller muscle fibers are weaker, but they have much greater endurance. And so depending upon what type of muscle contraction we need, we're going to activate these groups of muscle fibers to generate the amount of tension and type of tension that we require. Now, if you look at the top here, we can see that our small muscle fibers, right? These are cut ends of long fibers, right? Our small muscle fibers are innervated by smaller motor neurons, larger ones by larger motor neurons, and then the very largest, of course, innervated by very large motor neurons. We also know that the number of skeletal muscle fibers, a fiber being a cell, they're just long and skinny, so we call them fibers. But the number of cells being innervated by the larger motor neurons increases. And so obviously activating this motor neuron stimulates more target cells than a smaller neuron does. And of course, that's going to mean differences in the amount of tension and power that we generate. So what we see in motor unit recruitment is that as effort increases, right, effort being cerebral activation of the motor cortex to generate a muscle contraction. What we're going to see is as effort increases, initially, we're going to activate those small motor neurons and activate to contract in groups the very small, weak fibers, generating relatively low tension. As we increase our effort, we're going to get this sort of stepwise progression. And it's exaggerated the steps here, but we're going to get a stepwise progression of increase in tension as we bring in, right? So if our level of effort is here, we're going to have not only the small and weak fibers that generate tension down in this range, this lower degree of tension, you're also going to get tension due to this next group of fibers activated in larger motor units, right? And so now you start to get this level of tension developed by that group of fibers. And so on, right? And these would continue outward during stronger and stronger contractions. Finally, you activate these really big, really strong fibers with the highest degrees of effort to generate very high levels of tension. And that is called the size principle of motor unit recruitment. We're activating our motor units based upon their sizes and the sizes of their motor neurons in sequence. And we're recruiting them in order to generate different degrees of tension.